What's up, YouTube? My name is Clickwid, and I am back again today bringing you guys another Madden 15 Ultimate Team video a couple days before the game is actually going to be released. And today, guys, what I want to talk about is a little poll that I did on Twitter the other day. And I want to thank everybody prior to the video for participating. We had quite a few responses, so that made for a pretty nice set of outcomes, I think, for this video. But I really want to talk about the legends that are in Madden 15. Now, obviously, we had a ton of great legends in Madden 25, but I think there was kind of a few that were missing. And, you know, I had some off the top of my head that I really wanted in the game, but I wanted to hear what other people had to say, because I think that there's kind of a variety of answers. There's people that are looking for certain players and others that are looking for others. You know, for example, we would have the people who are fans of, say, the Denver Broncos, and they might say, I want, say, Rod Smith in the game, and maybe Steve Atwater, and, you know, those kind of players who are, you know, really popular in that exact market. But overall, as far as the grand scheme of the NFL goes, they're not really great sellers for the rest of the NFL community. So those players might not be the best options for adding to Madden 15. Now, what I asked on Twitter was for everyone to give me their top five most wanted legends for Madden 15 Ultimate Team. Now, like I said, we got a big variety of options and you know, a ton of different players that people suggested, but there were five that kind of stood out as the most commonly repeated players, the players that everybody seemed to want the most. So why don't we count down the top five most wanted players as voted on by my followers on Twitter. And if you guys aren't following me on Twitter, make sure that you head over to twitter.com/ClickwoodTV, or you can just type in @ClickwoodTV if you're at Twitter already. So let's go with number five to start things off, and we have Jim Brown. Yes, drafted in 1957 by the Cleveland Browns, he went on to win the Associated Press NFL Rookie of the Year and the NFL MVP award in the same season. Yes, his rookie year, he was also NFL MVP, absolutely beastly. Now, he would go on to win a total of 3 MVP awards, along with being selected to the Pro Bowl 9 times in his 9-year career. Now, Brown was the NFL's all-time leading rusher with 12,312 yards when he finally retired, and he held that record all the way until Walter Payton broke it nearly 20 years later. Now, obviously, Emmitt Smith has broken that record since, and, you know, Jim Brown isn't at the top anymore, but at the time, he was playing in a 14-game season, and he was absolutely destroying opposing teams. He proved that he still had the skills as he led the NFL in rushing in his final season, and Brown definitely was still an absolute monster, but there wasn't nearly as much money to be made in football back then as there is now, and he actually ended up deciding to pursue an acting career following the 1965 season. So most people who are around back then, our parents, and in some cases our grandparents, those people actually kind of would look back on Jim Brown and they would tell you that he is maybe one of the few players who played back then who could actually still legitimately be a great player in the NFL today. And for that, he actually is going to land as the number 5 player on our list of the most wanted legends in Madden 15 Ultimate Team. Now, because he actually played fullback technically, Brown might be kind of underutilized if EA actually made him that position with his mutt item, but his combination of speed and strength from the position would actually make him significantly better than like Mike Allstott was in Madden 25. So I definitely think Jim Brown would be a card that, or an item as they're calling them this year, a card slash item that people would definitely be looking forward to if he was added. Moving on to number 4, while Jim Brown retired in 1965, a new era of dominance came on the opposite side of the football when the Chicago Bears drafted future Hall of Famer Dick Butkus. In his rookie season, Dick Butkus did it all for the Bears and showed everyone why he would go down as the NFL.com's top 10 player of all time when he led the Bears in tackles, interceptions, forced fumbles, and fumble recoveries in his rookie season. Butkus was an 8-time Pro Bowler, and the only season that he was not selected to the Pro Bowl was in 1973, and that was because he missed significant time due to multiple knee injuries, which would unfortunately end his career. Now, many remember Butkus for a famous 1970 Sports Illustrated cover, which actually captioned him as the most feared man in the game. And I think that although he probably trailed behind some of the newer age players in terms of like speed, his strength, hit power, tackling, play recognition, and that kind of stuff would make him possibly the best overall middle linebacker in Mutt 15 if they ended up adding him. Moving on now to number three, one of the most polarizing figures ever to play the game. It should come as no surprise that Terrell Owens makes our list as one of the top five most wanted legends for Mutt 15. Owens took a regular season snap for five NFL teams and could realistically have items as a member of either the Cowboys or the Eagles, but what we'll actually do is focus on the 49ers because that's where he spent the biggest part of his career and where he accumulated four of his six career Pro Bowl seasons. Now, as it currently stands today, Owens is second in the history of the league with 15,934 receiving yards. Only Jerry Rice stands above him, and he's also third all-time with 153 career touchdown receptions, which leaves him only behind Rice and Randy Moss. Now, although he might have lacked the straight-line speed as maybe some of the other top guys might have had, like somebody like a Randy Moss, for example, Owens had an amazing combination of strength and incredible size. He was 6'3" and 225 pounds, and he was also known as one of the best blocking wide receivers of all time, which means that he would definitely make himself a spot on my roster if I was one of the people who likes to run the football like I normally do. Now, his Mutt item would probably be one of the most impossible to defend players just because of that combination of speed and strength and the blocking. Like I said, he would just be an absolute beast. I think everybody would be looking for him, and I would definitely love to have a Terrell Owens on my team personally. Moving on now to number two, and we have one of the most legendary players ever, the NFL's all-time leader in passing yards, completions, touchdowns, and yes, even interceptions. That, of course, is Brett Favre. Now, although he probably stuck around too long, the Madden 09 cover athlete, Brett Favre, was reportedly still getting offers from NFL teams to make a return during the 2013 seasons. I've actually heard that the Rams were looking to sign Brett Favre last year. Yes, as crazy as that sounds, once Sam Bradford went down, they were looking for any and all options. But the three-time Associated Press NFL MVP is now enjoying retirement, and he's helping out with the local college football team, I think it's the high school football team, but he would be an unbelievable Mutt card, or Mutt item as they're being called this year. I'm trying to make sure that I get down the lingo, but it's a little bit hard. I think I'll eventually get it, but Mutt item, Brett Favre's Mutt item would be incredible. It would be amazing in the categories of like toughness and injury, but his arm strength would be insane. I wouldn't be surprised if he would be the first and possibly the only card in the game that would have 100 attribute in terms of throwing power. So while his decision-making skills might be a little bit shaky from time to time in terms of the numbers on his Mutt item, I think that when we're considering that we actually user control the quarterback on every play, that's something that we don't really need to worry about. So Favre, if you consider that he was actually more elusive than most people give him credit for, he would have a crazy arm and be elusive and have great accuracy, deep, and all of the things that you would look for. He would be almost like a better version of Steve Young, possibly. Maybe like with that kind of speed and elusiveness, but a stronger arm. Just like the regular Steve Young from Mutt 25 is what I'm thinking of. But and then obviously if they do Ultimate Legend cards again this year, he would be even crazier. So I think that Brett Favre would be one of the most fun players. I think that everybody would be looking for him. And he should definitely be a player that the NFL looks for, that Madden looks for to add to Mutt 15 if we still have that possibility. Last but not least, the number one player by a landslide was one who made it to almost every single person's list, and that was former Los Angeles Raiders running back Bo Jackson. Now, this one was particularly interesting to me because I don't think most of the people who voted for him have ever even seen Bo Jackson play. But the stories themselves about this guy are legendary. Bo Jackson was one of the greatest college football players of all time. He won the 1985 Heisman Trophy Award and then made his NFL debut in 1987. He hit the ground running right away with his incredible athleticism that made him a two-sport professional athlete. Yes, he also played baseball professionally. But unfortunately, Bo Jackson could never stay healthy. He played only 38 games in four seasons before finally retiring from the NFL in 1990. His Mutt 15 item, though, would be insane. I mean, think Barry Sanders. Seriously, that combination of incredible speed, elusiveness, but he also had the bruising trucking ability that would make him one of the best overall players in the whole game. I think that he might possibly be the best overall running back if he were to be added to Mutt 15. Unfortunately, he'd probably be with the likes of like Danny Amendola, Mike Vick, and Darren McFadden in the injury category, so that would be pretty tough to deal with. But still, Jackson would be so much fun to play with, and he's gonna round out the top five of the most wanted NFL legends for Madden 15 Ultimate Team. So what do you guys think? Do you guys agree with this list? I mean, who do you want to see in Mutt 15? I don't know that they have for sure locked down everybody that's going to be in the game or not, but if they haven't, I want you guys to leave it in the comment section below. Let me know who you guys want to see. One player that didn't make many people's lists that kind of surprised me, and this is one that I really wanted to see, was LaDainian Tomlinson. Now, I know Tomlinson hasn't been out of the league for very long, but at the same time, though, he was an absolute monster in his day. And we're talking like best running back seasons of all time level greatness from LaDainian Tomlinson. And that's probably, it's possibly because he hasn't been out of the league for very long that I think maybe people aren't really looking back on it so fondly at this point, because we're still kind of thinking about his New York Jets days. But man, when he was first coming into the league for like those first 5, 6, 7 years that he was with the Chargers, he was insane. He was an absolute beast. I remember playing with him in like Madden 06 and just destroying people because he was just by far and away the best running back. So I would love to be able to play with LT one more time, or I should say LT 2.0, one more time in Mutt 15. That would be an absolute blast. I know that there's some sort of contract situation going on between him and the NFL, and it's making it a big pain in the ass, but I wish that they could just put that aside and get us LaDainian Tomlinson, because I would have a blast playing with him. He would almost certainly be the guy that I would go for as my running back. So with that being said, I want to actually do a quick shout out. Because you guys have been seeing these awesome graphics on here, and I want to make sure that I give a shout out to the appropriate people who are really busting their asses for this. Because there are people out there, and as soon as the cards were released, they were doing this. These guys are going out there and they're making custom versions of Madden 15 Ultimate Team cards. Or items, as they're being called. I have to remember that. But anyway, I want to do a quick shout out for Chase Holdu. And I apologize, Chase, if I'm pronouncing your name incorrectly. Chase is one of the most awesome members of the Ultimate Team community. He has been making cards for people for free for quite some time, and he is doing an incredible job with them. We're not just talking about Mutt 15, we're talking about Mutt 25, and I think he might have even been doing them before that. So, I mean, he does an amazing job, as you guys have seen with these cards. He did them on such short notice for me, so I want to give a shout out to him. Like I said, make sure if you guys are not following him on Twitter that you go over to his Twitter account, which is S-H-A-C-E-H-O-L-D-U, and give him a follow. Thank him for putting together these cards, and check out some of the other work that he's doing, because it's crazy. He does an amazing job with these items, and I really do appreciate it. I appreciate all the work that he puts into them. I know how it is. I know how much of a pain in the ass it is to do graphics and that kind of thing. I really didn't want to go in and try to create my own template for these items because it was going to take me longer than I really wanted to, but he had already made the template and he was able to kind of put the cards together and really make things look nice for me. So I really do appreciate it. Thank you again, Chase. I really do appreciate it. You're the man. And make sure if you guys are not following some of the other custom card creators that you look around on Twitter, because there are a bunch of people that are doing these things. They're doing an insane job. They make better looking stuff than the real developers do, in my opinion. So definitely go check those out and let me know what you guys think about those guys in the comment section. Give Chase a shout out. Tell him thank you for doing these graphics for me if you guys would in the comment section. Thank you guys for tuning in. I do appreciate it. Again, make sure you guys let me know in the comment section below if there are items that are not on this list in terms of the top five legends that you guys are looking for, because I want to hear it from you. I want to know what you guys want to play with. Thank you guys again. If you're new to the channel, make sure you go over and press that subscribe button, because that's the best way for you to stay updated when I post a new video. And if you enjoyed today's video, of course, make sure you press that like button so that we can kind of promote it and hopefully get more views and that kind of thing, grow this channel and grow the community even more. Thank you again for watching. I do appreciate it, guys. And I will talk to you beautiful bitches again soon.